What's up, guys? Before we get to our marble challenge, we're gonna hit some PT work and go over a few things you can do with Voodoo floss to add to your warm-ups and get ready for big lifts. Check it out. If you're new to CrossFit or Olympic weightlifting and you wanna know more tips and tricks on how to improve your technique, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any content. All right, for today, I brought in Taylor Payne, physical therapist out of Greenwood Lake, to come and talk to us about Voodoo floss. Taylor, thanks for coming out.
Of course.
Awesome.
So Voodoo floss is a tool that not a lot of people use, but it is a very versatile tool that you can use for a lot of different things. It is kind of stretchy, and you can use it as a resistance band, but as far as the mobilize it category goes, I'm gonna give you guys a quick way to keep your elbows healthy and make sure that those forearms that sometimes with weightlifting can get a little bit sore feel a little bit better. So Joe is going to be my volunteer here. Any kind of Voodoo floss works, right? You want to make sure that it's not too tight, that you feel your fingers when you're rolling that elbow, okay? So Joe's going to make his arm nice and straight for me. And what you're going to do with this is you're going to kind of start it maybe, 2 inches or so away from the actual elbow joint. And you're gonna wrap it with a little bit of tension, but you wanna use maybe just half of the roll each time you put a wrap around the arm, okay? What you don't wanna do is cover that joint space, right? You wanna leave a window there. So you're gonna go around the back of the elbow, up onto the bicep as well. Because with the Voodoo floss, one of the coolest parts about it is you can move with it on, right? It's not a passive tool. You wanna make sure that it's not too tight so that you can still move. And what you're gonna do with the end of the Voodoo floss is just tuck it in so it stays on while you're moving. Okay, so it looks just like this when you tuck it in. Joe, can you feel your fingers?
Still feeling them.
Okay, good. And what I want Joe to do here is just to bend and straighten his elbow. So all of the muscles that are underneath the Voodoo floss get mobilized between the skin and all the fascia that's around it. And he can do, maybe 5 or 10 reps. And if he feels like he's feeling ambitious that day, you can try certain things like push-ups or overhead.
This is with the Voodoo floss on. When you're done,
you want to make sure that you take it off nice and slow so that it doesn't squish any of your skin, for lack of a scientific word, okay? So that you don't get any bruising or anything like that. And you want to make sure that you test out that joint again once it's off to see if it feels better or maybe it feels the same. You want to do that again maybe 2 or 3 more times. You can do that with any joint in the body.
I feel great.
All right, so we hit the elbow up. What can we do with the knee?
So with the knee,
there's a lot of different locations around the knee that can be tight when doing things like squatting, right?
However, since elbows are very similar to the knees in the way that they move, you can actually wrap the knee almost the same way, making sure that you keep the back of that joint open, like a window, if you will, in the back. So can I borrow your knee?
All right.
So with this, always you want to start the floss away from your body, right? So I always say go from your toes towards your nose when you're dealing with the leg. Okay, so I'm going to start kind of a little bit down on the shin, similar to the elbow, about 2 inches away from the joint. You want to make sure that you have that same tension and tightness coming around. Again, using about half of that tape to advance the floss up the leg, making sure that I'm not clamping down the back of this joint, so I'm gonna kind of create a diagonal to skip over the top. And you always wanna make sure that you cover that first piece of the quad, because that seems to be the spot that gets really sore when you're squatting and lunging a lot. Okay, and then you're just gonna continue up the leg so that you can try to do some of those movements like bending and straightening the knee and squatting. So let me just finish up this tape for you. I wanna make sure that it stays tight and stays on. Because that can happen. The first time you try to wrap the knee is always kind of tough, so it might come apart if you don't quite get that last piece of it tucked in there. So you could try a number of things. Try to bend and straighten the leg if you want. Good. And even try some squatting. Beautiful. And the tape's gonna move a little bit with your skin, and that's normal.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right, so with the floss, what's something that is you see a lot of where people need to start using floss in their warm-ups?
Yeah, so the floss can be used at any time. It can be used for warming up, for training, but it can also be used on recovery days just for mobilization and making you feel better. In the weightlifting world, one of the things that a lot of people tend to struggle with, or even in the CrossFit world too, is we do a lot of pulling, right? So your forearms can kind of get beat up after a while, and the biceps too. So using the floss to kind of warm up, increase the mobility in that area, because really what it does is it helps to mobilize the connective tissue between the muscles and the skin, and you can just feel like you can move better, right? So it creates a neurological window to do that. So in warm-ups, you can just bend and straighten the elbow, or you can do things like push-ups, overhead presses, or whatever the functional movement is that you want to feel better with the floss on. But it's also important to do it with it off after you give it a
test. So is this something you would do before pain or during? Like if you had a tennis elbow or a golf elbow, is it something to do with that?
Yeah, so typically when you're struggling with a tennis elbow or a golfer's elbow, it's something that kind of knocks on the door before it actually happens, right? So you have one training session where you're like, oh, that kind of felt funny, you know? That's a perfect time to start using it. Or you can use it all the time, right? As something that's preventative and helps you just feel better in general. So kind of anytime. But if you are training and you're having a lot of pain while you're training and it's stopping you from moving in a way that you want, it's always important to make sure that you talk to one of your local area health practitioners, if it's your doctor or your physical therapist or whoever you've dealt with before in the past for pain. Just hit the stop button and make sure that you talk to somebody when you think it's somebody, like a time that you actually need to say something.
All right, now that we got through our PT work, we're gonna head right into our challenge, but I'm bringing in the big guns for this one. We're gonna hit 3 cleans and 1 jerk, the Taylor special. We're gonna take about 10 minutes, hit up this one, check it out.
For me, lie, do not waste me.
All right, guys, that was our 3-in-1 clean and jerk special, the Taylor special. Thanks for coming out, Taylor.
Of course.
Awesome having you. Hit this one up. Let us know how you like it. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure you watch all our videos. We'll see you next time for the next one.